You've seen it on the big screen many times. Scientists become aware of a massive asteroid hurtling towards Earth, and humanity's only hope is to send a team to plant a nuclear bomb inside the approaching monster. Despite many alarming setbacks, the intrepid team ultimately succeeds, and the asteroid explodes into millions of pieces. Movies like Deep Impact and Armageddon make it look so easy. Surely nuclear weapons that can destroy entire cities have enough destructive power to shatter a giant space rock, right? The answer is both yes and no. For starters, asteroids come in all shapes and sizes. Ceres, the largest known asteroid, stretches 580 miles and 933 kilometers in diameter, while 1991 BA, one of the smallest asteroids on record, measures 20 feet 6 meters in diameter. An asteroid larger than 6.2 miles in diameter is considered extinction class, or powerful enough to wipe out life on Earth if it collided with our unfortunate planet. Technically, a nuclear bomb could destroy a smaller asteroid, but it's not these smaller entities that pose a threat to Earth's security. What is truly worrying is that asteroids larger than 400 meters cannot be easily destroyed by such a bomb. Of course, large pieces may break off, but it is not enough to eliminate the danger. A NASA report published in 2007 noted that placing a nuclear bomb on or below the surface of an asteroid would likely cause it to break into several pieces, and that large pieces of an even larger asteroid could still be quite dangerous if they hurtled toward the asteroid's surface. If the asteroid is made of more flexible material, then it will probably absorb the explosion. So how powerful was the asteroid that destroyed the dinosaurs? Located in Mexico, Chicxulub Crater is approximately 180 kilometers by 110 miles wide, and is the second largest confirmed impact crater on Earth. This huge size shows that the asteroid is quite large. Most estimates place the asteroid between 6.2 and 9.3 miles in diameter, or 10 to 15 kilometers. However, some studies suggest a slightly smaller size, such as 4.3 kilometers and 2.7 miles if it is a long-period comet. To put this in perspective, Mount Everest, the world's tallest mountain, is approximately 5.5 miles by 5.5 miles high. So even the lowest estimates show that the asteroid is larger in diameter than Everest. We can list additional factors as follows. 1. Composition. The composition of the asteroid can also affect the size of the impact crater. A denser, metallic asteroid will leave a smaller crater than a less dense, porous one of the same size. 2. Impact angle. The angle at which the asteroid hits the Earth also plays a role. A shallower impact angle will spread the energy over a larger area, resulting in a larger crater. If we want to compare this asteroid, which is large on Mount Everest, with an atomic bomb, it is approximately 100 times larger than the atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima. Such an energy explosion not only creates huge tsunamis, but also rains fire. In fact, most of the flying creatures in the region died by having their wings burned like this. Others were destroyed by the smoke released by the asteroid into the air. So where do this asteroid that destroyed the dinosaurs or such large asteroids come from? While we can't determine exactly where the dinosaur-killing asteroid came from, scientists have suggested several possible areas of origin, based on evidence from the Chicxulub Crater and cosmic dust studies. 1. Inner asteroid belt. Located between Mars and Jupiter, the inner asteroid belt is one of the regions with the highest density of asteroids in our solar system. Studies suggest that a collision in this belt may have sent asteroids into Earthward orbits, with one of the asteroids eventually finding its inevitable destination. 2. Outer asteroid belt. This expanding region beyond the inner belt contains various asteroid families and celestial bodies. Some theories suggest that an interstellar event or other collision in the outer belt may have dragged an asteroid onto a path past Earth. 3. Extinct comet family. Although less common, some models suggest that the asteroid may have come from a now-extinct family of comets. After breaking apart, some comets can release asteroid-sized fragments that could potentially encounter Earth over long periods of time. 4. Other solar system regions. Beyond the familiar asteroids and comets, the vastness of our solar system holds undiscovered celestial bodies. Although less likely, some scenarios suggest that the asteroid may have originated in regions such as the scattered disk, or even interstellar space, and encountered Earth through gravitational interactions. This question comes to my mind about this asteroid that destroyed the dinosaurs. Why didn't this asteroid burn up in the Earth's atmosphere? What was the asteroid that destroyed the dinosaurs made of? This asteroid is a Class C asteroid, the most common type of asteroid in our solar system, and is known for its dark, carbon-rich composition. This asteroid that reached Earth is a carbonaceous chondrite. That is, it contains high levels of carbon, water-altered minerals, and organic compounds. What I mean here is that the asteroid that destroyed the dinosaurs was not metal or anything. It was an ordinary asteroid. Imagine a metal or diamond astronaut falling to Earth. Maybe this is how the moon was formed, when Earth collides with another planet like Theia. Let's get back to our topic. Does it make sense to drop a nuclear bomb on an asteroid? Planetary defense researchers have created a simulation of what would happen if we dropped a nuclear bomb on an asteroid. And on paper, dropping a nuke on an asteroid has advantages over a mission like DART, according to the simulation. The biggest one is energy, because nuclear devices are capable of producing more energy per mass than any human technology. Since space launches must always minimize mass, a nuclear warhead can deliver a much more powerful hit than a DART-like spacecraft could achieve. We then detonate the device or deflect the asteroid, keeping it intact, but providing a controlled push from Earth, or disrupting the asteroid, breaking it into small, fast-moving pieces that will also miss the planet, said Berkey. Although it's a favorite disaster movie theme, dropping a nuclear bomb on a real-world asteroid has been touted as a very bad idea. While a nuke could probably destroy a smaller asteroid, dropping a nuke on a larger asteroid would only blow it to pieces. These fragments will still threaten our planet and perhaps make the situation worse by creating multiple effects on the planet. A nuclear explosion transmits most of its energy in the form of X-rays. If a nuclear explosion were to hit an asteroid, this powerful radiation could pass over the asteroid and potentially vaporize any material unlucky enough to get in its path. Berkey and his colleagues developed their model to simulate these effects on four different asteroid materials and under a variety of conditions. So is using nuclear weapons against an approaching asteroid really a bad idea? If the correct technique is used, a nuclear explosion could possibly be used as an asteroid deflection tool. Researchers at Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory have created a modeling tool that can simulate what would happen if a nuclear device were detonated on the surface of an asteroid. The tool helps understand how radiation from a nuclear explosion interacts with the asteroid's surface, and also looks at shockwave dynamics that could affect the asteroid's interior. Explosive technique called nuclear ablation, where the radiation of the explosion vaporizes part of the asteroid's surface, creating an explosive thrust and a change in velocity and response. The model can include a wide range of initial conditions that simulate the types of asteroids we have recently been able to examine up close, from solid rocks to piles of rubble. These simulations give planetary scientists more information and more options about when a space rock might someday arrive on Earth. Thanks to the Double Asteroid Redirection Test, DART mission, in which a kinetic impactor deliberately crashed into an asteroid to change its orbit, scientists have learned a lot about what to do to redirect a dangerous asteroid. This new model, called the X-ray energy deposition model, gives researchers the tools to leverage information from DART to explore how nuclear ablation could be a viable alternative to kinetic impact missions. But as the team wrote in their paper published in the Planetary Science Journal, predicting the effectiveness of a potential nuclear deflection or disruption mission depends on accurate multiphysics simulations of the device's X-ray energy deposition on the asteroid and the resulting material ablation. In summary, although dropping a nuclear bomb on an asteroid approaching the Earth or deflecting asteroids may seem like a dramatic solution from science fiction, it is a complex and potentially risky approach with uncertain results. Exploding asteroid particles can gain incredible kinetic energy and fall to Earth. Current space agencies and scientific communities are focusing on developing safer and more reliable methods for asteroid deflection, such as gravitational attractors and kinetic impactors. These methods, currently under development, hold greater promise for controlled and predictable deflection of asteroids without the devastating and dangerous consequences of nuclear explosions. Yeah, we have come to the end of the video. Can we stop an asteroid approaching the Earth with a nuclear bomb? Don't forget to like the video and subscribe. Bye.